Welcome to the show. Today is Wednesday. Yeah, man. The way that day is rush, man. My flu is getting better. Thank you so much for praying for me, man. Do you even pray? But I feel good. I feel happy. I feel, man. See, yeah. Go to my face. The show is called Yap. I was about to tell you where to go, man. The show is called Yap. Reliable intelligence, man. And also, you're taboo. What was my interest about our award? We are helping you be better people. Hey, to Wakana. So we are always here Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Thursday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. At 8 p.m. 8 p.m. then 10, 8 to 10. So 20 days. So always tune in, man. What do you be doing with your life, man? Always tune in, man. Go on my social media. That is Tumusime. Separated. Tumu then Sime. Go to my YouTube, Tumu and Sime. Also, Tumu Sime. Subscribe. Then what work a day? You click on the bell so you get notifications. Even if like I have a sex tape. Then go to my Twitter and Instagram in case your life is boring. You can also go there and waste your data. It's at Tumsime UG. Man, thank you so much for the feedback. Thank you so much for always watching the show. I'm seeing some feedback on the videos on YouTube. You can also access, get these videos on the Urban YouTube channel. Yeah, YouTube, no searching Urban TV Uganda. So, man, there is a campaign that has started. And it's aimed to make sure that by 2021, Uganda is among the most clean countries in Africa. Is it most clean or cleanest? It's not that. I don't even know what they're going to do because they have to first cut out like the slums. You get like something and it cuts out like the whole of Katanga. You just put it up like this, then you see flies. And they carry it and they drop it in Lake Victoria. And they come back. Then they look for another dirty place. Which one? Lower Chikoni. By the time they cut out all the dirty places and they leave the clean places, Uganda will now be the size of like Rwanda. Man, but it's a good thing. I actually support it. That's a proud thing. Okay. Some people, there's a person, a friend of mine, traveling. You put on a white shoe and you walk around for like a month before you have washed it. He just jumps twice before he says, DJ, trucker number two. So what, how dirty is this country, man? But I hope this really works out, or this is really going to be hard. Man, it's going to be very hard. Because imagine cleaning this country, man. It's everyone litters. All those eyelashes that slave queens have to take off and throw on the streets, man. Have you ever gone like, I don't know if like where you stay, in your, if you're in a rental, maybe those of you who have your houses, you don't know this. But for Abacha Pangisa, sometimes you're going to like on the garbage bin, she was wearing this hair yesterday and I was crushing on her. Then you just look around. She comes and she passes, man. And the head is like from 70. It's just weird. This is a woman, man. Then after some time you come back to put in like another kasasiro, then you find the hair is not there. Because that means that there is another person in the neighborhood. Ye mwavu. She puts them on the tap, she washes them, soaks them, as take our linens, the color, then as Amber in Changa, Kati, we know Mukwanoga, and Funyum Kassing our bay. I don't know what Yamkasa Nagam Chibara, Nakugamba. She can't drink any alcohol below 200,000. Stay here. No man uses alcohol which are like this size, Bushot. Come to it, and if you are not, stay here. Come back. You picked hair from dustbin. I'm going to clean the whole of Uganda, man. Now, I hope that these people are going to clean this. We'll be serious this time around. Not these jokes, man. Some of the, have you ever seen like these posters of Keep the Kampala Clean? Some of them even look like they were designed by a comedian. You might think of Isaac Atolwa, we designed them. When you talk about don't urinate here. Fine. Which urine is worth 500,000? How can you say that me urinating on the side of the road, I should be fined the entire net worth of Michael Ross? There's a lot of money, man. At least, you say, don't urinate here. 8,000, bargainable. Stigger. So you know, then Ningamba, no Savakana Ningamba, Ninamu and Kumi B. Then we agree like on 4,000. Stigger. And it's actually a funny man. Like sometimes even the people that write them, you find that they are not well spelt. Man, this Ugandan is like a joke, man. How can someone try to enforce a law of keeping a city clean? Not even know English, eh? You find they have written, don't urinate here. But the urinate they have written is a one of L, of long. Stay here, man. And what is always funny is that after they have put, like, don't urinate here, you see, like, a dog coming and he raises the leg and So for it, when it sees it, it thinks maybe it's a decoration. Actually, that also begs an important question. If Eddie Kenzo urinates, can you arrest him? Because later, man, you kusoma. So you would don't urinate here. Now, soma, for him, he thinks maybe it's yellow. We see that, we say, no, you're NRM, mobile money. Ah, now, fuck. So again, Kato, do you arrest him or do you give him a reduced sentence? What about if we're going to clean the city? Are we also going to remove everything that looks dirty? Are you going to remove these random police guys who are always in town who don't wash their uniforms? They also look dirty. God, about to have a takeover, man. Like, it's just hard, man. It is hard. Like, jokes aside, the reason why it is so hard to make a city clean is to change the mindset of people. That is the hardest thing, man. Because umuntu wabanga atachategera, ira jakuria bisumbuso babichia akavera akakasuka wechitegera. To change that. To change the mindset of people, that is hard. That is harder than bad black writing like an English essay, man. Chizibunyo, mochitegera. To change people, if you want to really change people, you have to do it gradually. You introduce it in schools. You introduce it everywhere. You, by the time you said it, it might take like 10 years, man. Because the truth is, it's easy to make a city clean if people have it in their head. So that means that you have to now get influencers. You get people that people look up to, and you make them clean so that people can look up to them. For instance, you know that people look up to Chameleon. You go and you beg Chameleon, you say, Chameleon, please start bathing. So that people and it starts to look fresh. Because people there can also start bathing because over 2 cents the water. But imagine if Chameleon doesn't shower. Now what about these people that follow him, but our Papa CD? These funny, funny flies running after them. The reason I say that you should change the mindset is that in society, cases where we have been successful in changing mindset, it has actually worked. Like me, I never used to think that you can ever change the mindset of border people. And they act like they have brains. I have always had this argument. And to Mundawa border, Abanji, not every border guy, of course, but most of the border guys, if you take him for brain surgery and you remove his brain, and you're going to put him on a border without a brain, there will not be difference. Wait, so all along he wasn't using his brain, we could have gotten it out and we give it to someone else who might need it, like Helen Lukoma, or Fabiola, Stegera. They don't use their brains at all, man. But surprisingly, these guys who are wretched, is that wretched the right word? That one is used in fornication. Who are like careless with their lives. They were transformed by just these applications of borders, man. Have you noticed that these boys of borders that use applications, they are so normal. Like, you feel like you're the one driving the bike or riding the bike. The guy reaches a traffic light and he stops. When was the last time you saw that, man? A person on a border? Man, so at the end of the day, we have to think that all border are stupid. They're not stupid. It's just that the mindset, by natural mindset, you have to make the most money. But if you actually bring something that can transform their brain, man, sometimes we're going to go to border app. Guy, first ask the boys, can you meet them at the same time? What? You just feel like, what? Am I dreaming? Because most of these border guys, when they call him, immediately he gets all both his hands and he starts to look for his phone when the border is speeding, man. Leaving all you guys' fate in the hands of the Almighty, man. And also, if you're going to be enforcing this mindset change, also trying to clean Uganda, try to make sure that you pick out places which actually have a real actual shot at being transformed. Don't do it for. There's some places in Uganda which you have to just give up on. They will never be clean. Like, to somewhere, you cannot go and you say, you're going to clean YC. No, man. No. You start with places that look like they have hope. So YC, the only thing we can do, you can go on Google Maps and you strike a deal with Google. They first get it out of the Google Maps and they say, when you search for YC, they say, location and found. So that we first tied it. So you start with places which look like they have hope. Like, I don't know, Namgongo, Chaiwajara, which other place? You know, even some places in the village, they're actually clean. They are cleaner than places in town. It smells fresh. Now they see people who use like what kawala. Usangomia yengalunde mbizi au sitting room au nukamba. We msejagwe. How is the pig in the sitting room eating on the same plate as your daughter? Shitegera. Okay, maybe that's an exaggeration. Neba lunde mbizi au kunyumba. And pigs smell, man. Hey, man. What do you know, like when a city queen has been partying like for 3 days and just running from Bazinga, she has not yet gone home. That's how pigs smell. So some of these places, you have to give up on them, man. Like Nakulabi. Now, how do you get Nakulabi? How do you get that out of Nakulabi? First of all, they sell that. So when you come and you say, get the dirt, get this dust, we say, man, you're messing up with the raw material for our income. The only thing that is hypocritical is that, let's say this campaign was to ever be successful, and they managed to actually clean Uganda. The corruption, the rotten politicians. Isn't that like the saddest part to this story? To have a very clean country, but a very rotten soul of operation, man. Oh, man. And you step in Kampala and it's clean, it smells fresh. And when politicians start to speak, you're like, Sure, it's called Yap. It's called Reliable. Okay, Yap Reliable Nonsense. But man, I'm always ashamed to say the nonsense part, but that's what it is. Yap Reliable Nonsense. We're always here on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday at 8 p.m. Always tune in. Take it. Even if a woman has promised to give you some, tell her, wait for 10 minutes. Lol, I know that one. I can't compete with that. But who knows, man? Until tomorrow, same time, have a good night.